This section of the Global Problems course deals with human rights. We talk about where the ideas and the passions for human rights came from. We focus on some of the inherent tensions and limitations built into key aspects of the human rights movement. We cover some of the key enforcement mechanisms for human rights, but also why they frequently break down. Human rights raise a number of fascinating topics in the contemporary world. Why should people care about freedom of religion or torture halfway around the world, affecting other people with whom the only connection is a common humanity? Why, on the other hand, have such compelling standards, standards like freedom of conscience or freedom from abusive punishment, not been more uniformly successful? Why do there continue to be so many violations and disputes? What, indeed, are the major problems associated with human rights? Should the focus be on the abuses, on the gaps between standards and reality? Or should it focus on the interference which human rights advocates try to impose on quite different cultural traditions? Both the deviations from standards and the often acrimonious debates about interference are problems worth exploring. The goal is to present a clear introduction to what human rights are all about, but also to encourage discussions about limitations, contradictions, and future directions. Further comments and additional materials will be welcome as we build a fuller statement about human rights as a global problem area and gain additional perspectives. There are few global problems where regional points of view are more varied, though it is important to note that there are passionate defenders of common human rights standards almost everywhere in the world today. And what should the next steps be in this field? Do we need further expansion of the range of human rights, as well as better enforcement? Or do we need to pull back from so many absolute standards and admit key regional and national differences? More rigor or more compromise and flexibility? Additional debate is inescapable, and we need the information and analysis that can make debate both informed and, hopefully, constructive. The issues are not abstract. Human rights ideas and efforts have rescued political prisoners in Central America from prison or worse. They have persuaded governments to rescind the death by stoning of a woman accused of adultery. They helped persuade the United States Supreme Court to eliminate the death penalty for minors, and they helped end apartheid in South Africa. The list of achievements is long, and it draws from examples in most parts of the world. But disagreements about human rights and their priority are real as well. They have led to anti-American riots in the Middle East over disagreements about what religious freedom and freedom of the press are all about. They generate recurrent tensions between the United States and China, seriously complicating this important relationship. They have led to periodic disputes between Europeans, including the Catholic Papacy, and Americans over the death penalty. The issues and arguments, in other words, are part of the fabric of contemporary globalization and global news. How did this field become so complicated?